Hello friends, I am Professor Arun Nandurbarkar from EC Department, LD College of Engineering, and in this session we will be discussing the number system. So I assume that we are having a prerequisite kind of information regarding the number system, like binary number system, decimal number system, hexadecimal number system, and the octal number system. So in this particular session we'll be discussing more on this number system, but in a different way. So what is going to be covered in this particular session? I will be discussing mainly on the negative number and how do you represent the negative number. So there are three methods: sign and magnitude method, one's complement method, two's complement method. After that, we will mention regarding the overflow issues in this numbering mechanism. And then in the last slide, we will discuss several miscellaneous topics regarding this negative number or miscellaneous issues regarding these negative numbers. So how do we represent a negative number as a human being? We say, for example, -23, we write down the number by writing down minus sign just beside that particular number. It means that prefix for the symbol with a minus sign is sufficient to represent a negative number. So we use a minus symbol to represent a negative number, that it is a -23 number. So to represent a negative number, there are basically three approaches. One is the sign and the magnitude. The next approach is the one's complement, and the third approach is the two's complement. Now all the three approaches can be used, but they can also be used to represent the positive number. It means that we can represent a positive number and a negative number with the help of sign and magnitude method. We can represent a positive number and a negative number with the help of one's complement method, and we can represent a positive number and negative number with the help of two's complement method. It means that although we are discussing the negative number, it is possible to represent also the positive numbers with all the three approaches that we have mentioned it over here. So our first method for representing a negative number is sign and magnitude. So how do we represent the sign of the number? We know that we are referring to a positive number if we are having a zero as the most significant bit, and one represents a negative number. So in the most significant digits or bit, if we have zero, we understand it is a positive number. And in the most significant bit, if we have one, then we understand that it is a negative number. Now, apart from the most significant bit, whatever digits are there, those bits are representing the number's magnitude. Now, let us refer to an example. Now suppose we are having some number like 0, 1, 1 and 1. Now this number we refer to most significant bit first of all. Now we have to first of all be clear regarding what kind of method that we are referring. So it is a sign and magnitude. It means that our first digit that we have to inspect is the most significant bit, which will represent either it is a positive number or a negative number. So this zero indicates that it is a positive number, and rest of the particular bits are representing the magnitude of that number. And we know that this basically represents 7. It means that it is a positive number having a sign is equal to 0, that is there, but it is having a magnitude is equal to 7. So we say that it is 07, say that it is plus 07 in the decimal format. Now the same number, let us refer in this context that we are having 111, all four ones are there, and since it is represented in the sign and magnitude format, we inspect the most significant bits, and it is a one is the most significant bit, so we understand that it is a negative number. Now then we have to find out what is the magnitude. So we say that rest of the bits are representing the magnitude. So the rest of the bits are 1, 1 and 1, and we know that it is representing equivalent decimal number is equal to 7. It means that this particular number that we had represented is nothing but minus 07, or we can say it is minus 7. So this is how we represent the number with the help of sign and magnitude, whether it is a positive number or it is a negative number. So now let us refer to the slide in which we are having all the numbers are there starting from 0 to 7, and the negative numbers are also there, minus 1, minus 2, up to say minus 7. So here what we are able to see is that if you want to represent the positive number, then there is no problem, because positive numbers are our normal convention with the help of the bits that we are normally referring and representing the number. We try to write down the numbers. So if you want to represent the positive number 0 up to plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 and so on up to say plus 7, we can represent in the normal format. But if you want to refer to say negative numbers, so negative numbers are basically most significant bit is 1. So we can see on the circle that the on the left hand side of the circle we are having the negative number, which are 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, up to say minus 7. So if you observe, then we find that the most significant bit for this negative number is equal to 1 in all the 8 options, and rest of the 3 bits represent the magnitude. So what is the problem in this sign and magnitude method to represent the negative number? So problem number 1, that there are 2 representations for a number 0. So plus 0 is represented by 0, 0, 0, 0, 4 times 0, and minus 0 is represented by 1, 0, 0, 0. So 1, 3 times 0. We can go back and to the previous slide, we can immediately notice this particular difference, that in the previous slide we were on the right hand side, we are having plus 0, which is represented by 4 times 0, and on the left hand side in the corner bottom we are having a number of say minus 0, which is represented by 1 and 3 times 0. So this is problem number 1 with the sign and magnitude method. What is problem number 2? Problem number 2 is that arithmetic is not appropriate, or we say that it is cumbersome. And how it is cumbersome? For that we take an example, that 4 minus 3 is not equal to 4 plus minus 3. Although both the expressions should result into the same answer, but they are not the same. Now let us refer and how we try to calculate that why they are differing. So 4 plus 3, if we go by normal addition, then there are no problem. So let us refer to our normal addition and let us try to write down the addition of these two numbers, that is say 4 and 3. So how do we represent number 4? It is 0, 1, 0, 0. And how do we represent number 3? So it is 0, 0, 1 and 1. So since these two are the positive numbers, there is no problem regarding the addition of the two positive numbers, and the answers that we find is 0, 1, 1 and 1. And in the decimal notation, this is the decimal number, and the expected answer in the decimal should be 7. So we say it is 7 with the basis of say 10, and the equivalent answer in the binary is 0, 1, 1 and 1. Suppose if we try to make the subtraction of these two number, that is say 4 minus 3, and we know that this 4 minus 3 will result into 1 as our answer. So it is our decimal answer, right? Now let us try to subtract in these two number, that is say 0, 1, 0, 0, that is our number 1. So it is 4. So we are trying to subtract 4 minus 3. So our second number is 1, 0, 1 and 1. Why we are representing this 3 by with the help of sign and magnitude method? So we always remember while we are doing this arithmetic that this number is a sign and magnitude kind of representation. It means that the sign of this particular number is negative, and that is why we are having most significant bit is equal to 1 over here, and the rest of the 3 bits are representing the magnitude. So since the magnitude is 3, it is represented by 0, 1, 1 and 1. So now let us try to make the subtraction. We are having the two numbers, one is 4, another is minus 3, with the help of sign and magnitude method. So what the answers that we get? 0 minus 1. So it is not possible, so we have to take the borrow. So how do we take? We take the borrow from its neighbor, isn't it? Now what is the neighbor? Neighbor is digit is equal to 0. So it cannot provide the borrow. So we go back to the next neighbor. And what is the next neighbor? It is equal to 1. So this 1 is possible for applying the borrow. So it can give some borrow to the neighbors. And we can say that this borrow is taken from the neighbor. So 0 minus 1 is equal to 1 after taking the borrow from the its immediate neighbor, that is say middle 0. And the since we are having 1 which is borrowed from its neighbor, so 1 minus 1, the answer of subtraction is equal to 0. Now we go back to the third digit, which is 0, after, because this digit has already given the borrow, so from 1 its value will become 0. So 0 minus 0 is equal to 0. Finally, we are having a particular last digit is equal to 0. So 0 minus 1 is also equal to, here also we are finding some borrow. So this answer does not seem to be correct, and we have to slightly correct our number. So let us say that once again we want to subtract this number 4 minus 3, correct? And answer is equal to 1. So 4 is nothing but 0 1 0 0 and 3 is nothing but 1 0 1 1. So if we try to subtract, basically 0 minus 1 is equal to 1, then 0 minus 1 is also equal to 1. This 1 minus 0 is also equal to 1. And finally 0 minus 1 is equal to 1 after taking the borrow. So this is not the number 1 after subtraction. So what do we do? The appropriate thing would have been 0 1 0 0, right? And we are trying to subtract 3 from 4, so it will be 0 0 1 and 1. And now we can apply the subtraction. So 0 minus 1, so it is 1. Then 0 minus 1, it is equal to 0, because there was some borrow was taken from this particular 1. So here then we can say that here 1 was there, and 1 minus 0, so 1 has already been taken over here, so 0 minus 0 is equal to 0. And in the fourth digit it is 0 minus 0, it is equal to 0. So answer of this subtraction in this manner, if we go by sign and magnitude method, that 4 minus 3, we get this answer as equal to 1, which is correct. And if we go in this particular manner, this answer is not correct. So what is the solution? Solution, we can go back to the slide. What do we do over here is that, suppose if we want to subtract the two number, that is say minus 4 plus 3, we know that our normal answer is equal to say minus 1, because minus 4 plus 3 is equal to minus 1. So how do we represent minus 4? We represent minus 4 by 1 1 0 0, which is the in the last row, last column of this particular table. And how do we represent plus 3? We represent plus 3 by 0 0 1 1. So if we try to add these two number, that is say minus 4 plus 3, as indicated in the last column, then it will be 1100 + 0011. What is the answer of this addition? It is once again 1111. And that is not the answer of say minus 1. So what do we do is that we try to compare and subtract, which is written on top of the third column. So we know that our first digit was a higher digit having a higher magnitude, which is say minus 4, and we are trying to add plus 3 with the minus 4. So we can make the comparison, and after comparing we try to subtract from higher number to the number which is having a lower magnitude. So ultimately it is a high number minus low number. So 4 is basically represented by 1100, and the next number is a 3, so which is having a lower magnitude. So we try to subtract 1100 minus 0011, and we get the answer is equal to 1001. So if we compare our normal answer of the decimal subtraction, what is the expected answer after say normal say arithmetic, minus 4 plus 3, the expected answer is equal to minus 1. And if we had made the comparison and subtraction and had done the subtraction, then we have got the answer is equal to 1001. So it is a number represented in the sign and magnitude format, that is say it is a number nothing but minus 1. So here we are exposed to the two problems of the one's complement sign and magnitude kind of say method, in which there are two problems are basically discussed. One is that there are two representations of 0. For positive 0 we are having 0000, and for negative 0 we are having a number called 1000. So we cannot have the two representations of the same digit, that is say plus 0 and say minus 0, because plus 0 is equal to minus 0. The representation of both the 0 should be equal. The second type of problem that we had mentioned it over here is regarding the arithmetic subtraction, that is say 4 minus 3 is not equal to 4 plus minus 3. So what is the typical solution for the problems that we had faced in the sign and magnitude number? So the second approach is the one's complement method. So in the one's complement method, the negative numbers are basically represented by its complement of the positive number. So if you want to represent say 7, positive 7, then the number is represented as 0, 1, 1 and 1, which is in the decimal format. And if you want to represent minus 7, then minus 7 can be represented by complementing the bits of the binary number represented by digit 7. So we have to invert this particular bit. Now let us refer to any other example. Let us refer to an example over here where we want to represent some number, that is say 0101. So friends, it is a one's complement method. So we remember that we are trying to represent a number with the help of one's complement. So here 0101 is some positive number, and it is nothing but a number 5 in the decimal numbering system. And if you want to represent say negative 5, in the decimal number system. So what do we do is that we have to take the complements of the bit. So here we are having 1. So we have to take the complement and 1 will be represented by 0. Similarly, we are having a second bit is equal to 0. So we have to take the complement of 0 and here we have to write down 1. Similarly, we are having third bit is equal to 1. So to represent this number minus 5, we have to complement and we should write down 0. Similarly, the last bit is equal to 0, and since we want to represent in the 1's complement, we have to write down 1. So all the bits, wherever you find 0, it should be written as 1, and whenever you find 1, it should be written as a 0. So this is how in the 1's complement method we represent the particular number. Now let us refer to this particular slide in which we are representing the numbers on a circles, and on the right hand side we are having the 8 numbers which are the positive number starting from plus 0, plus 1, plus 2 up to say plus 7. On the left hand side of the circle we are having the negative number, and they are minus 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 up to say minus 7. So we can see that in the 1's complement format also we are representing the number on the circle, but we are able to represent only 8 plus 8. It means that total there are 16 possible numbers which are represented, because if you count the number, how many numbers are represented on the circle, we can count that plus 0 is one number, plus 1 is another number, up to say plus 7. So on the right hand side there are 8 positive numbers which are represented on the circle. On the left hand side of the circle we are representing minus 0, minus 1, minus 2 up to say minus 7. So 8 negative numbers are represented on the left hand side. So this is a kind of say notation, and let us see what is there in 1's complement. Now here also we can try to do the arithmetic in the 1's complement method. And we can say that if we want to try to add the two number 4 plus 3, so here an example is given where some arithmetic operations are being done with the help of 1's complement method. So in the first column, simple addition is being performed, which is say 0100 plus 0011. So basically in the first column we are trying to add number 4 with number 3, or in other words we are trying to add 4 plus 3. So the expected answer in the decimal notation is equal to 7, and the equivalent binary numbers are basically written, and the answer in the binary number system would be 0, 1, 1 and 1. So this is the normal addition in the 1's complement. Remember friends, here we are having the two positive numbers, so we don't have to bother regarding the negative number. Or we can say that since we are not having a negative number, we are not performing any complement of the bits. Now let us refer to the second column in this particular example, where we are trying to once again perform the subtraction of 4 minus 3. So we know that the answer of this arithmetic operation 4 minus 3 is equal to 1, and equivalently we have written those numbers on the right hand side by having the addition of the two number. So we are having a positive 4 number which is represented by 0100, and we are having a negative number. So we know that negative 3 is basically represented by 1100 by taking 1's complement. So here we have taken the negative number by taking 1's complement of the equivalent positive number. So what is the answer of these two addition of these two numbers? The answer of addition 0100 plus 1100 in the second column comes out to be all 0, and we are finding that there is some carry is generated, and whatever carry is generated, that we have to add. So ultimately whatever addition was there, we have to add the carry, and after adding the carry we get the answer is equal to 0001. So this is the expected answer, because the answer of this subtraction 4 minus 3 should be equal to 1, and after adding the carry we get our final answer is equal to 0001, which is the correct answer. Now in certain case we may have the first number having the higher magnitude, or in this example let us refer to the third column where we are trying to add minus 4 plus 3. So in the normal expected answer in the decimal notation will be minus 1, because minus 4 plus 3 is equal to minus 1. Now for this particular one, what we are doing is that minus 4 is a negative number, and this negative number should be represented by 1's complement. So the minus 4 is represented by 1011, which is basically 1's complement of a positive number. The positive 4 is represented by 0100, and we have to take the 1's complement for representing a negative number, that is a minus 4. Now the second number is plus 3, and since it is a positive number, we do not require to take the 1's complement in the second number. So we try to add these two number, that is say 1011 plus 0011, and we will get the answer is equal to 1111, 3 times 1, and 4th is the 0. So it is a negative number, because in the 1's complement if you try to see what is this number, so if we refer to the previous slide, in that we are representing a number minus 1 with the help of 3 times 1 and 4th is the 0. So this is the correct answer, because it was a minus 4 plus 3 operation. Expected answer should be minus 1, and in the 1's complement method we are getting the answer which is the correct one. So if we compare the sign and magnitude method, then it is solving our arithmetic problem . Now let us try to understand why the 1's complement is working in this particular manner. The 1's complement of a 4-bit positive number y is given by 1111 to the basis of 2 minus say y. Because what we are doing is that we are basically inverting the bits. So wherever we find 0, we represent by 1, and 1, wherever we find 1, it is nothing but 0. So now let us refer to an example. Suppose we were having a number minus 7. Right, so minus 7 number we want to represent in the 1's complement format. right? So normally we know that 7 is basically represented by 0 and 3 times 1. And to take the 1's complement, what is mentioned in the slide, that we have to subtract this number from 4 times 1. So if we do that, we will get 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, and 1 minus 1 is equal to 1. So we are getting a number is equal to 1 and 3 times 0. So this is basic operation that we are doing. So if we compare, what was our original number? So this is a 1's complement. And our number, if we only compare, the magnitude was 0, 1, 1 and 1. So basically, wherever 1 was there, we replace it by 0. So second 1 was there, we had replaced it by 0. And similarly, we had replaced the rest of the 2 digits by taking the complement. So this is basically mathematical operation that we had performed. Now let us look into the slide. So whatever operation that we are doing for representing the negative number is nothing but subtracting the number from all the 4 ones as far as the 4 digit number is concerned. And what is 4 times 1 to the basis of 2? We know that 4 times 1 to the basis of 2 is nothing but 1 less than 1 and 4 times 0 to the basis of 2. So what is the number 1111 to the basis of 2? It is a number slightly less. What is that slightly less? It is only 1 less by compared to the number 1 and 4 times 0. Now this 1 and 4 times 0 is nothing but 2 raised to 4. And this particular 2 raised to 4 is there. And we are trying to subtract one number out of that. So basically 111 is nothing but 16 minus 1, we can say, or we can say it is a 15 number. If we go want to represent minus y, then minus y is basically represented by this 111 minus y. So it is nothing but 2 raised to 4 minus 1 into bracket and minus y. So what is wrong? So still we have the two representations of the zero. So if somebody has noticed, we can go back to the ones complement in the previous slides. So here we are able to see that plus 0 is represented by 0, 0, 0, 0, and minus 0 is represented by 1, 1, 1, 1. So there are two different representations of 0 in the 1's complement. It means that plus 0 and minus 0, they are represented in different manner. So what do we do in this particular problem? So solution is basically given by 2's complement. So it is another method of representing the number. Basically, it is used for representing the negative number. But as we had mentioned, that it is a generalized method, either you can represent a positive number or you can also represent the negative number. Both the types of numbers are possible to represent with the help of 2's complement. So whatever earlier problems that we had mentioned regarding the arithmetic or the two different representations are eliminated over here. So what is the 2's complement method? So we take the bitwise complement of the particular number and we try to add 1. So we can say that it is a bitwise complement plus 1. So if we do that, then we are able to represent the number in the 2's complement format. So in this particular example, we are having a number 7, which is a positive number in the decimal digit. We can represent with the help of 0, 1, 1 and 1. And if we want to represent minus 7, then we have to invert those digits plus we have to add 1. So let us look into an example for that. Now let us look over here where we are having some number and we want to represent in the 2's complement format. So let us say that we are having a number 5 in the decimal format. The equivalent binary representation is 0, 1, 0, 1. Now, if you want to represent, say, minus 5, which is a decimal number and it is a negative number, but we want to represent in the 2's complement format. So, what do? The first step is that you have to take the 1's complement, we can say. So how do we take the 1's complement of this number 0101? We have to invert the digits. Wherever 1 is there, we write down 0. Similarly, second is 0, we write down 1. The third digit is 1, there we write down 0. Finally, we are having a 0, so we should write down 1. So this is the 1's complement. And then whatever is the answer of 1's complement, we have to add 1. So if we add 1, what we will get is 1, 1, 0 and 1. So this is our answer. So this answer is a 2's complement number. And this number is nothing but our number minus 5. So this is how we can perform the 2's complement of any number which are negative by taking 1's complement and adding 1 into the number. Now let us look into the slide. Now if you refer to the circle on the right hand side, several positive numbers are represented and on the left hand side several negative numbers are represented. So on the right hand side, the positive numbers that are represented are 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, up to say plus 7. On the left hand side of the circle, we are representing the numbers which are minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, up to say minus 8. So here we can see that it simplifies the arithmetic and it is having only 1 0. So although 1's complement, we were able to simplify the mathematics, we were getting the correct answers, but the 2 zeros were represented in the 1's complement. So that problem is basically solved in the 2's complement format. But here also we find some asymmetric representation in the sense that if you refer to the positive number, right, positive numbers are ranging up to plus 7, in 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 only, up to say plus 7. While your negative numbers are basically represented starting from minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, up to say minus 8. It means that the negative numbers are having more magnitude, or the positive number, maximum magnitude of the positive number represented with the help of 2's complement is less compared to the negative limit. Or in other word, we can say that the limit of negative number is higher than the limit of positive number when they are represented with the help of 2's complement. So this is still asymmetry, but still there is a single representation of 0, and arithmetic also there are no problems. So it is the most popular method which is used for doing the arithmetic operation compared to sign and magnitude as well as the 1's complement method. So let us look into the example what actually 2's complement is doing. So in this table, our first column refers to the addition of the 2 number, which is 4 plus 3. So we know that our expected answer should be plus 7. So how do we represent this plus 4 in the first column by 0, 1, 0, 0? Because we know that it is a positive number, so we do not require to take 1's complement and add 1. So we are representing the positive number as it is, that is say 0, 1, 0, 0. Similarly, we are having a second number which is equal to plus 3. So it is a positive number, and since it is not a negative number, we do not require to take 1's complement and add 1 into that. So it is a normal representation of plus 3, 0, 0, 1, 1. And now we are trying to add the 2 number in the binary format, and we refer to the answer in the first column. It comes out to be 0, 1, 1, 1. So it is a normal answer. 4 plus 3 is the expected answer is equal to plus 7. After binary addition also, we are getting 0, 1, 1. It is also the expected answer. So decimal expected answer and the binary answer after doing the addition is also correct. Now let us refer to the second column of this particular example, which is mentioned that we have to invert and add. So in the second column, we are supposed to perform the arithmetic operation of 4 minus 3. Now this 4 minus 3, the expected answer is equal to 1. So what is plus 4? Plus 4 is represented as 0, 1, 0, 0. And minus 3 is represented as 1, 1, 0, 1. So we know that since minus 3 is a negative number, we have to represent it with the 1's complement, and we have to add 1 also to get into the resultant 2's complement representation. So our minus 3 is 1, 1, 0, 1. So ultimately now we are ready to perform the addition of these 2 binary numbers. So one number is plus 4, another number is minus 3. And if we do the addition in the binary format, then we will get the answer as 0, 0, 0, 1. And we are also getting one carry, and that carry we are supposed to drop it. Then we will get the correct answer as equal to 0, 0, 0 and 1. So what was our expected answer of the operation? 4 minus 3 should be equal to 1. And here, after inverting and adding and ignoring or dropping the carry, we are getting the answer is equal to 0, 0, 0, 1. Now let us refer to the last column of this particular table where we are trying to add some number minus 4 plus 3. So we know that minus 4 plus 3, answer of this arithmetic operation is equal to minus 1, because the first number is higher magnitude. So how do we represent minus 4 number? Since it is a negative number, we have to represent in the 2's complement format. And how do we represent minus 4? It is represented by 1, 1, 0, 0. And the second number is a positive number. It is say plus 3. And we have to represent in a normal manner. So only for 2's complement representation is required for negative number. So the first number is the 2's complement representation. So if we try to add these two binary number, we get the answer is equal to 1111, which is basically a minus 1 answer in the 2's complement format. If you want to refer to the slide, we can go back and just cross check. So here, if we refer to the circle where we are representing minus 1 number by 4 ones in this manner. So whatever answers that we have got is the correct answer after getting the invert and addition, we can say. So in this example, whatever we had seen is that we are trying to add to positive number, then it is successfully added. If we try in the second example that we had seen with the help of 2's complement, 4 minus 3, so subtraction is also successful. And in the third example, we had performed the subtraction of minus 4 plus 3. So where the first number is higher, then also we are able to get the correct answer in the 2's complement format. So what is the reason that 2's complement is working? Let us try to find out why it is working actually. So let us say that a 1's complement of a b bit positive number y is 2 raised to b minus 1 minus y. So as we had seen in the 1's complement method, that we are subtracting 2 raised to b minus 1 minus y. So 2's complement we have to add 1. So ultimately your number minus y is 2 raised to b minus y. So what is y and 2 raised to b minus y? They are equal, because when they are taken the mod of 2 raised to b, so these two numbers are equal. So mod is nothing but it is a remainder when the number is divided by 2 raised to b. And we ignore the carry, so we get the equivalent arithmetic is equal to 2 raised to b. So ultimately, the conclusion is that because the minus y number and 2 raised to b and minus y number, they are representing the same number because of this modular operation, we can say mod 2 raised to b, that is why 2's complement is working. And overflow is another type of the mechanism or issue that we can see. If we try to add 2 positive number, it can give the negative answer. And if we try to add 2 negative number, it can give the positive result. So here is an example where in the first circle, 6 plus 4, it will get the answer is equal to minus 6, and minus 7 minus 3 with the help of these 2's complement method, it will give us plus 6. So it is because of the overflow that we are getting the answer. What is the correct answer of 6 plus 4? It should be equal to 10. And what is the correct answer of minus 7 minus 3? It should be minus 10. But instead of minus 10, we are getting plus 6. And in the previous one, 6 plus 4 should be equal to plus 10, but we are getting minus 6. It is because of the overflow that we are getting this issue. And there are miscellaneous, say, things that we can mention in this regard. We can write down plus 6 and minus 6 as 2's complement in this format. And we can also extend the sign to the 8-bit by extending 0's and 1. And here there are several examples where we do not understand what exactly the number is. So I leave for you to just verify that these are several number, same number is there actually, but we cannot understand. So if we go for unsigned notation, then 11001 will be understood as 25 or 25. If we go for sign and magnitude representation, then the same binary number is represented or understood as minus 9. And if we go for 1's complement and 2's complement, the same number is basically minus 6 or minus 7. So it is again, the problem is there, problem regarding the type of the method. So we have to mention the type of the method that we are using. So thank you very much. In this particular session, we have covered the number system by assuming the preliminary knowledge regarding the binary, octal, decimal and hexadecimal number system. And basically we have covered the negative numbers in this session. How do we represent the negative as well as positive number with the help of sign and magnitude method, 1's complement method, 2's complement method, and the problems are associated with those methods are basically eliminated in the 2's complement method. Thank you.